Now it's time to talk about one of the most dangerous and powerful parts of a hurricane, and that is the eye. We know about the eye not just because we talk about it every year during hurricane season, but because if you've lived here in Southwest Florida long enough, you lived through it during Hurricane Irma just a few years ago, as the eye made landfall around Marco Island and then moved right up the coastline. We saw significant damage in a lot of our coastal communities as a result. So in this, we are going to talk about why the eye of the storm is the most dangerous part of the hurricane. But before we get there, we have to talk about how the hurricane and how the eye wall actually forms. And it all simply starts with air being drawn in from all around, from hundreds of miles around. So that creates the area of low pressure. Now, how does air getting squeezed into one part of a storm cause low pressure? You'd think that would create high pressure, right? Because once the air gets to the middle, it has to go somewhere, so it goes up. Well, once that air starts to rise, the pressure at the surface is lower, and the more air that fills that vacuum, the lower the pressure gets, and now you've got your storm. So once that air rises, it starts to create clouds, and eventually those clouds lead to thunderstorms. Now follow along, because all of this is going to be tied together. The stronger these thunderstorms are, the stronger that hurricane becomes, and the more well-defined the eye of the storm becomes. Why do hurricanes spin? Very simply put, and we're not going to go into a lot of detail here, it has to do with the Coriolis force, a result of the Earth's rotation, believe it or not. That causes wind to be deflected to the right, and that's why we see that counterclockwise spin in the Northern Hemisphere. But let's get back on topic here. The eye of the storm. Let's cut this hurricane in half and talk about exactly what creates these thunderstorms within and why we see this big gap in the middle of some of the most powerful weather that we have on Earth. So here we go inside the eye. We've got wind coming out on this side and then going back in on the other side. And in the middle, there's nothing there. So remember, with a hurricane, we're drawing air in from hundreds of miles. And once that air comes in, it starts to rise. And that's where we get our thunderstorms. These gray columns here, these indicate our thunderstorms and then our outer rain bands, which can go out for hundreds of miles. But why do those gaps exist in between? Because once the air gets up in the upper part of the storm, it has to go somewhere. And it sinks back to the surface. Sinking air prevents cloud growth, and it prevents cloud formation. So that's why we see these rain bands. In between bands of rain, we have dry slots, and that's that sinking air. Well, in the middle of the storm, it's the same principle. The air comes up from the eye wall and then sinks back down to the surface. And all of this is connected to the strength of the hurricane, because the stronger these thunderstorms along the eye wall are, the more well-defined we're going to have that eye, because the more air is sinking to the surface, and thus the stronger your hurricane. Let's give you the example of Hurricane Irma. You can find the eye wall very clearly defined here on the radar image. It's the yellow, it's the orange, and the red. This is where we get the heaviest rain and the highest sustained winds following along those arrows. Once that eye makes landfall, though, everything goes quiet. So within the eye itself, that's where we get that sinking air, which means no clouds and no rain. The strongest winds are now outside of the eye and everything is calm. But the worst is not over, because the back edge of the eye has to move through. And once that happens, we get a quick shift in the wind direction, and that is what causes the most damage. So if you ever go through a hurricane and you go through the first part of the eye, you have to go through the second part before the worst of the storm is over.
You know you need hurricane shutters, but what's best for your house? How do you even install them? I'm getting a first-hand lesson straight ahead.
Though hurricane season runs from June through November, September historically sees the most hurricane activity. By then, the ocean has been heated all summer long, and water temperatures are warm enough to allow more storms to develop.
Most homeowners and renters insurance policies don't cover flooding, so it's important you talk to your insurer and make sure you know what you're covered for.
If you have hurricane shutters, the National Hurricane Center recommends that you put them up when a hurricane watch is issued for your county.
COVID-19 taught us that water can disappear from shelves quickly in times of distress. Remember that you can store drinking water in clean tubs, sinks, and plastic bottles.
Don't be fooled by the calm eye of the storm. The worst part will happen once the eye passes over and the winds blow from the opposite direction.